Hi guys, this is Shivaidi. In this session, I am going to explain Angular lifecycle methods. Let's go ahead and start. Angular components are the building blocks of Angular application, which are going to represent the different parts of the user interface. So, Angular component go through a series of lifecycle events from the creation to the destruction phase. These events are the methods are going to help the developers to implement the specific logic during the component lifespan to perform certain actions or to execute that particular code. Let's go ahead and first look at the component, how to implement these lifecycle methods. So here I have created a component that is the lifecycle hooks component. Here I implemented the different interfaces. So in order to implement the Angular lifecycle methods, you have to implement these interfaces. So there are different type of interfaces: on changes, on init, do check, after content init, after content checked, after view init, after view checked, on destroy. So once you implement these interfaces, you need to override these lifecycle methods. First, let us go through the what is the purpose of each lifecycle method, and then we are going to execute this particular code and see how the flow of these lifecycle methods are going to be triggered. The first one is the constructor. This is the first method is going to call when Angular creates the component instance. So it is used for basic initialization. The next one is the ng on changes. Ng on changes is going to be triggered whenever an input property of the component is going to change, and this receives the simple object changes which contains the previous and current values for the properties. The next one is the ng on init. Ng on init is going to be invoked after Angular sets the component's input properties. It's generally used for initialization logic that relies on the input properties. The next method is the ng2check. ng2check is going to be triggered during the every change detection happen during the lifecycle. And after that, we have ng after content init. Ng after content init is going to be triggered after Angular projects external content into the components view. After that, we have the ng after content checked. This is going to be triggered after Angular checks the component projected into the component. And then the next lifecycle method is the ng after view init. Ng after view init is going to be executed when components view and child views are initialized, and it is going to be used for the task that require access to the rendered DOM. And the next method is going to be called is the ng after view checked. This is going to be triggered after Angular checks the components view and child views. And finally, we have the ng on destroy. So this is going to be used for cleanup activities, and also it can be used for clear the component. Now these are the different lifecycle methods. Now in order to implement these methods, as I said, we need to implement the respective interfaces. It may not require all these lifecycle methods has to be implemented. Based on your requirement, you can choose which lifecycle component is going to help you for your requirement, and where you can customize. So whenever Angular is going to load this component, it automatically triggers these lifecycle methods. Now let's go ahead and execute this code and see what is the output. Now here, localhost 4200 lifecycle methods. So this is the way this particular component is getting loaded. So if you look at it, first it called constructor, and then ng on init, and then ng do check, and then ng after content init. After that, ng after content checked. Then we have the ng after view init, and then ng after view checked. As if you see, this component is got loaded, and again it called ng do check, ng after content checked, and ng after view check called. Okay, so this is how the Angular lifecycle is going to work, and you can customize based on the requirement. You can customize the specific Angular lifecycle method so that your custom code will be executed automatically by these Angular lifecycle methods. So in summary, we have three different phases. Initialization phase. In the initialization phase, generally it will call the constructor, ng on init, ng after content init, ng after view init. In the case of content and view initialization, those things will be called like ng on changes, ng do check, ng after content checked, ng after view checked. And destruction phase, it is ng on destroy. If you look at this lifecycle methods in a flow diagram, it again depends on the what are the interfaces you are going to implement. Based on that, these lifecycle methods will be called. So constructor, ng on changes, if there are any properties, you define the component, and then you have the ng on init, ng do check, ng after content init, ng after content checked, ng after view init, ng after view checked. Finally, it is the ng on destroy. Thanks for watching. Have a nice day.